Good afternoon, everyone. It's been a long time. I'm Doc Stout. Going to get right into it with the opening of 36 packs of Gnomes vs. Goblins. This is exciting for me because I just logged on, got my packs. All right. See, we have all 36. I refer to this in the title as opening a box because I'm a magic player in paper. So, oh, they're trembling with anticipation, wanting to be opened. Yeah, and a typical display box has 36 packs, so let's get to it before these packs explode. Number one. Oh, I love that animation. Our rare is a hunter card, King of Beasts, 2/6 for 5, taunt, battle cry, plus 1 attack for every other beast. Seems okay. Whirling Zap-O-Matic for Shaman, 3/2 for 2 with Wind Fury. Velen's Chosen for Priest. Give a minion plus 2, plus 4, and spell damage plus 1 for 3. Meh. Antique Healbot, something I played in the arena over the weekend with. 3/3 for 5, but has a battle cry of giving you 8 health. And Stone Splinter Trog is the last one in the first pack. A 2/3 for 2. Whenever your opponent casts a spell, gain 1 attack. Alright, one down, 35 to go. Boom. Alright, first up is a druid card. A 4/4 for 5 named Druid of the Fang. Battlecry, if you have a beast, he turns into a 7/7. That could be interesting. Warrior, mech. One drop, 1/3 enrage, plus 1 attack. Seems fairly generic, but if there's a mech deck, which I think there is, could be okay. Piloted Shredder, another mech. This one's generic. A 4/3 for 4. Death Rattle, summon a random 2-cost minion. There's been a lot of talk about this Shredder, what it can pull, and how it can either hose you or completely turn the game around. Our rare for the pack is Siege Engine, 5/5 for 5. For a warrior, whenever you gain armor, give this minion plus 1 attack. Pretty cool. Hunter, 5-drop spell, Cobra Shot. Deal 3 damage to a minion and the enemy hero. Pretty cool. Minor removal that also goes to the face. A little expensive, though. Now, what do I know? If you've seen my arena videos, you know my card evaluation skills are pretty crap. All right, first up, Shaman card. A deal 3 to 6, overload 1 damage spell for 2. We're seeing some of the Gnomes versus Goblins high variants here. Seems pretty sweet for 2 with overload, though. Overload 1. Our rare for this pack is a Warlock Mech. 4-drop, 3/5, Fell Cannon. At the end of your turn, deal 2 damage to a non-mech minion. Paladin 2-drop spell, Seal of Light, restore 4 health to your hero and gain plus 2 attack this turn. Seems kind of okay. A generic 4-drop 3/5, Burly Rockjaw Trog. Whenever your opponent casts a spell, gain plus 2 attack. And another Warlock card, a 4/4 for 5, a Floating Watcher. Whenever your hero takes damage on your turn, it gets bigger to plus 2, plus 2. Seems okay. Takes damage on your turn. That seems like it's a card with a little bit of combo potential. I mean, I guess every time you life tap, it gets bigger. The Flame Imp, I guess, would trigger it as well. All right. Next pack is start with a Gnomergon Infantry. Another one I played in Arena. A 1/4 charge with taunt for 3. Generic. Next up, we have another Floating Watcher. Another Crackle. Another Druid of the Fang. And our rare is a Druid card. A 2/4 for 3 named Grove Tender. Choose one. Either give each player a mana crystal or each player draws a card. Huh. I gotta think about that one. Alright, 32 packs left. That's a lot of packs. First, another Grove Tender right off the kick. Another Burly Rockjaw Trog. Another Warbot. Another Cobra Shot. Oh, complete dupes. At least I guess I have a set now. I'll be disenchanting some cards today. Another Gnomergan Infantry. Another Druid of the Fang. Already some disenchant fodder. Snow Chugger, a mage mech. 2-3 for 2. Freeze any character damage by this minion. Neat. Seems pretty efficient. Okay, a generic mech named Mechanical Yeti. 4-5 for 4. Death Rattle, give each player a spare part. Spare parts are random minor effect cards. I've only played with a couple of them over the weekend. And our rare is Hunter. Call Pet. 2-drop spell. Draw a card. If it's a beast, it costs 4 less. That seems pretty good. All right. First 6 are down. We got 30 to go. Nice long trip through this. All right. First up, we have a Lost Tallstrider. It's a generic beast. 5-4 for 4. Just pretty efficient in a vanilla sort of sense. Got a spider tank. It is a generic mech. 3-drop, 3-4. Seems fine in the theoretical mech deck. Another mech. Another generic. 2-3 for 2. It's got a little tribal effect here. Your mechs cost 1 mana less. Our rare is a Shaman Power Mace. It's a weapon, it looks like. It's a 3-drop that has 3 attack and 2 durability, and has a death rattle. Give a random friendly mech +2/+2. Epic! And an epic, our first epic. Oh, I liked this card for its combo potential. It's a mage spell, 4-drop, Echo of Medivh. Put a copy of each friendly minion into your hand. I'm very happy to open this. I foresee building a mage deck with this and getting some serious blowouts late game. All right, first epic. All right, we've got a 1-4 generic mech for 3 named Flying Machine. He's got Wind Fury. Seems okay. Another Burly Rock Jawtrog. I think that's number 3. Another Floating Watcher. That's definitely number 3. Hunter mech. Named Metal Tooth Leaper, he is a 3-3 for 3, who has a battle cry of giving other mechs +2 attack. And our last card is our second copy of Antique Healbot. Next up, boom! Alright. Rare off the top, Shaman Totem. It's a 0-3 totem for 2, Vitality Totem. At the end of your turn, restore 4 health to your hero. Seems okay? Another rare. Unfortunately, it's our third or fourth Grove Tender. Ah, we have a new weapon here. It's a warrior weapon this time named Ogre Warmall. It's a 3 to cast. It's got 4 power and 2 durability and a 50% chance to attack the wrong enemy. Sweet. Another Cobra Shot, like number 4 or 5. Second Snow Chugger. Pretty big set, but I've got play sets of a few cards already. I've got an Ogre Brute. He is a generic 4-4 for 3 with a 50% chance to attack the wrong enemy. Another Gnomergan Infantry. Second Call Pet. We've got a mage spell named Flame Cannon. It costs 2 and deals 4 damage to a random enemy minion. And a Whirling Zap-O-Matic. It is a mech for the Shaman class. It is a 3-2 for 2 with Wind Fury. Seems really sweet. I'm definitely going to want to build some mech decks. Alright, from the top, we have an Explosive Sheep. It is a generic mech. It's a 1-1 for 2, but it death rattles to deal 2 damage to all minions. Aw, yeah. Piloted Shredder is another generic mech. 4-3 for 4. Death Rattle summon around. Oh, we already got one of those. Another Call Pet. Tinkertown Technician. He is generic 3-3 for 3 with a battle cry. If you have a mech, gain +1/+1 and add a spare part to your hand. Neat. Oh, if you've watched my series, you know I love the Murlocs. I don't know that a 3-2 for 2 with no abilities makes it into the deck, but I'd have to consider replacing some of the 2-drops that have not been performing for me of late. Yeah, I might want another one of him, just to test him out. All right. Another Ogre War Maul. Another Explosive Sheep. Shrinkmeister. He's a priest. I think this is our first priest card. He is a 3-2 for 2 with a battle cry of give a minion negative 2 attack this turn. Sweet. Another Tinkertown Technician. Like saying that one. And our rare is a priest. Light of the Naru. Costs 1 for a spell that restores 3 health. If the target is still damaged, summon a Light Warden. My apologies if you're showing up in chat. I do not have the second screen set up. I've been struggling with the extended maintenance all day, so I just rushed in to open these packs as soon as I could. Thanks for watching, though, if you're hanging out in chat and I am not talking to you. Okay, our rare off first. It is a generic, all-class, 3-2 for 3. Gnomish Experimenter. Battlecry, draw a card. If it's a minion, transform it into a chicken. Okay, so card advantage, sort of. Seal of Light, that's our second one of those. Salty Dog, it is a 7-4 pirate, generic for 5. The Annoyatron, and I love the picture of this guy. 1-2 for 2, generic mech with taunt and divine shield. And a third Snow Chugger. Alright, we got number 23. Oh, epic off the top. It is a generic epic called the Recombobulator. It is a spell. No, it's a creature. What does this thing do? It's a 3-2 for 2. It has a battle cry of transform a friendly minion into a random minion with the same cost. I don't understand that, but I think I want to try it. Another Lost Tall Strider. Another Cobra Shot. Another Shrinkmeister. And another Mech Warper. A lot of dupes. A lot of dust coming out of these packs. Had to expect it opening 36 at once, though. Alright, another Druid of the Fang. Micro Machine. This one's new, I think. It is a all classes, generic, 1-2 for 2. He's a mech that at the start of each turn he gains plus 1 attack. Our rare is a Siege Engine. I think we opened this already. 5-5 for 5 that gets plus 1 attack when you gain armor. Another Micro Machine. This is a first for me, opening two of the same common in a pack. And the Gilblin Stalker. I had to play against this guy all weekend. 2-3 for 2 with Stealth. Seems pretty good. 21 packs left. I'm never going to get sick of that animation. Another Annoyatron. Our rare is another Light of the Naru. Like Floating Watcher number 5 or something. Ship's Cannon. Whenever you... Okay, this is a 2-drop, 2-3 generic. Whenever you summon a pirate, deal 2 damage to a random enemy. So they're trying to also make a pirate tribal sub-theme in this expansion. And Explosive Sheep, I already have my playset, but that's okay. I'll love me some Explosive Sheep. 20 packs left. Starting with our second Salty Dog. New Druid. Mech. 2-2 for 2, named Anodized Robocub. Taunt. Choose 1, plus 1 attack or plus 1 health. Seems pretty... I like the art on that. That's pretty cool. Another Ogre Wormall. Our rare is Mech Bearcat for Druid. It is a 7-6 mech for 6. Whenever it takes damage, you get a spare part. And another Number Gun Infantry. Neat. 19. Is this too many packs? I don't know. I'm getting myself set up for the expansion, though. Starting with a rare, a generic Goblin Sapper. He is a 2-4 for 3. He has plus 4 attack while your opponent has 6 or more cards in hand. A little bit of an answer to Handlock, it looks like. Be a 6-4 against that.
Golden Comb? common.
Golden common. He's a golden anodized RoboCub. This is our first golden card.
Rare.
Another rare. Matter Bomber. I play with Mad Bomber in several decks, including my Paladin Death Rattle. I don't know that at 5 I want this guy, but he's a generic 5-4 for 5. He's got a battle cry, and he shoots 6 damage between all other characters. That just seems so dangerous. I'll probably try and jam him in something, though. Another Stone Splinter Trog, and another Seal of Light. 18 left. Once again, if you're just joining me, my apologies if you're hanging out in the Twitch chat. I will be mirroring this on YouTube, but I do not have the Twitch chat open on my second screen today. All right, first up, our Cobra Shot number 1 billion.
Rare.
Our rare is the Arcane Nullifier X21. It is a generic mech that is a 2-5 for 4 mana. He's got taunt, and he cannot be targeted by spells or hero powers. That seems actually pretty good. The Goblin Auto Barber. This is for a rogue. I don't think we've seen so many rogue cards. It is a mech. It's a 3-2 for 2 with a battle cry of give your weapon plus 1 attack. Warlock Spell. Costs 2 Dark Bomb. Straight up deal 3 damage. I have a difficult time evaluating that since I almost always play aggros. Lock. Golden Rare. Sweet. Siege Engine. This is our Siege Engine number at least 3. I will probably be disenchanting that for that sweet, sweet dust. 17 packs. Alright. Another Tinkertown Technician. A Force Tank Max. I can't remember if we've opened one. I know I played with this over the weekend. A 7-7 mech for 8 with Divine Shield. Generic. Ship's Cannon we've gotten already. Power Mace we've gotten already. And an Epic Hunter. 2-3 for 2. Steam Weedle Sniper. Your hero power can target minions. That's awesome. 16 packs left. I think they're starting to go faster as I'm getting more duplicates. Another Floating Launcher. Another Force Tank Max. Flame Cannon. Did I have this one already? 2-drop spell, deal 4 damage to a random. Yeah, I think so. A rare is Scarlet Purifier. I know I played with this guy in Arena. It's a Paladin card. 4-3 for 3, and he's got a sweet battle cry. Deal 2 damage to all minions with Death Rattle. And the Whirling Zap-O-Matic. We already got one of those guys. 15 packs left. We're more than halfway there, kids. Velen's Chosen. That's at least number 2 of that. Shielded Minibot. Divine Shield Mech 2-2 for 2. Only usable by Paladin.
Rare.
Our rare is Lil Exorcist. Generic. 2-3 for 3. Taunt. Battle Cry, gain plus one for each enemy Death Rattle minion. Nice. Flame Cannon. We got some of those. And another Snow Chugger. Sweet. Alright. Second Gilden Stalker. This is our second copy of the very first rare we opened right at the beginning. Another epic. Oh, sweet. A dupe of Echo of Medivh. So I now have a playset. Another Tinkertown Technician and another Floating Launcher. 13 packs left. Looking. Another Mech Bear Cat. I'm so looking forward to building a mage deck with Echo. Another rare, only it's like Grove Tender number 9. Another Dark Bomb. Another flying machine? I can't remember if we've gotten this guy yet. There's so many mechs. It's sort of generic. I know we've gotten plenty of him, though. This is apparently the expansion where what I can open is Cobra Shot and Floating Watcher.
Rare.
Shield Maiden. This is new. 5-5 for 6, usable by Warrior, Battlecry. Gain 5 armor. Mechanical Yeti. Pretty sure we got one of those already. I know we got a bunch of him. Cogmaster. I think this guy's new. 1-2 for 1. Generic. Has plus 2 attack while you have a mech. And now we have a playset. Getting down to the wire here. Anodized Robocub number 3 or 4. Another Flame Cannon. Our rare is a second Vitality Totem. Third Goblin Stalker. And a bunch of Mech Warpers. I don't think I got a single new card in there. Last 10 packs. I had no expectations about wanting a single card aside from Echo of Medivh, even though I don't really play Mage that much. Another Mech Warper. Recycle, this is new. Druid spell for 6. Shuffle an enemy minion into your opponent's deck. That's interesting sort of removal. Dark Bomb, number 3 or 4. Snow Chugger, number billion. And another Dark Bomb. Number 9. Alright. First up, a Clockwork Gnome. 2-1 for 1, Death Rattle at a spare part. I don't know if he's new or not. Ogre Brute. That's at least a second one of him. There's another Clockwork Gnome, so if that was a first, I'm all set. Our rare is another Grove Tender. So much dust. Oh, this is new. Glaive Zooka. Some sort of bazooka that shoots spinny blade things. It's a weapon. 2 power, 2 durability for 2. Battlecry, give a random friendly minion +1 attack. I think that's good. I don't know. I don't play Hunter, really. Another Clockwork Gnome. Another Recycle. Another Snow Chugger. Another Cobra Shot. Another Anti-Keel Bot. Nothing new there. Last 7. Another Micro Machine. Target Dummy. He is a 0-2 for 0 generic with Taunt. That's pretty funny. Another Micro Machine. Another rare. I can't remember if I've already got 2 Power Maces or if that just completes my set. Oh, and an Epic. Lots of... Wow, 2 rares and an Epic in here. This guy's new, too. He's a Shadow Bomber. 2-1 for 1. Battlecry. Deal 3 damage to each hero. Interesting. Very aggressive. Crackle, number lots. Ship's Cannon, number at least 3. Rare's new, though. Shaman. He's a 5-4 for 4. Dune Maul Shaman. Wind Fury Overload 1. 50% chance to attack the wrong enemy. So if there's only 2, you got a pretty good chance of getting it. And another Tinkertown Technician. It's still fun to say. Alright, 5 packs left. Alright, first up, we've got our rare, another Light of the Naru. Another Ogre Wormall. Another Dark Bomb. Another Clockwork Gnome. And another Anti-Keel Bot. Nothing cool there. 4 packs left. Another Velen's Chosen. Another Goblin Auto Barber. Our rare is another Gnomish Experimenter, another Salty Dog, and another Velen's Chosen. Still nothing new. Come on, 3 packs left. Boom. Another Anti-Keel Bot, another Tinkertown Technician. Our rare is the Ogre Ninja. It is a rogue card. 6-6 for 5 with stealth and a 50% chance to attack the wrong enemy. Sweet. Warrior Warbot. I think I have that already. And another Explosive Sheep. That might be my favorite common in the set. Not as fun to say as Tinkertown Technician. Alright, only 2 packs left of the initial 36, or box quantity as I called it. Another Mechanical Yeti. Another Tinkertown Technician. Our rare is another Little Exorcist. Ship's Cannon, and a Golden Common for an Ogre Wormall. Definitely Disenchant Fodder. Last pack, everyone. I'd like to thank you for watching. I will do so again in just a moment, but here we go, because I don't know how often I'm going to buy more of these. All right. Another Anodized Robocub. Another Anodized Robocub. Another Mech Warper. Come on, something exciting. Epic will do it. Feign Death. New one, too. Okay, it's a hunter spell for two. Trigger all death rattles on your minions. That's sweet. I already have a death rattle deck, but that would be so good. And a rare. Another vitality totem. All right. Well, I'd like to thank you for tuning in, whether you're watching live on Twitch or whether you are checking out the archive on YouTube. I will probably be building decks and heading back to streaming. This has been my first video in a while because I've been pretty unsatisfied just doing my dailies and getting ready to get the gold to do this. You can always find me on YouTube at DocStout076, here on Twitch as DocStout. And you can catch me on Geek Life Radio Saturdays at noon as part of the crew for 40 Going on 14. And we're also on the Musings of a Geek podcast network. Once again, thank you very much for watching the launch event here. Opening a box, 36 packs of the new Gnomes vs. Goblins expansion for Hearthstone. This is Doc Stout, and I am signing out.